Hello and welcome to my channel. Hope you are doing well. In this video, I would like to share how I created this. Before getting into the topic, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you are new to my channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. To create this animation, I am using stock images and stock videos from various sites. I can provide you the link of the websites, but I can't provide you the files since they are copyrighted. Sorry for that, but I will surely leave the website links in the description below. Let's get into the topic. Open up After Effects, create a new composition. I am using a 1920 by 1080 composition with the frame rate of 30. The duration of 6 seconds. I am naming this composition as text. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing my last name. Create another text layer. You can type your own text. I am using my first name. I am stacking up the two text layers, one below another. I am using Arial font for both the text layers. As well, I am using different font sizes for the two different text layers. Create a new composition. I am using the same 1920 by 1080 composition with the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 6 seconds. I am naming this composition layer as Metal Text. Drag and drop the text composition which you have created earlier into the metal text layer and duplicate the text composition layer twice. Turn off the visibility of the first text layer. In the effects and presets panel, search for fill and apply into the second text layer and choose the color as black. Search for simple choke effect from the effects and presets panel and apply into the second text layer. Set the choke matte value to 5 so that we get the stroke kind of effect. Choose the second and third text layer and right click to pre-compose them. Name the layer as text stroke. Click on the move all attributes and click OK. Now turn on the visibility of the first layer and turn off the visibility of the text stroke layer. Bring in the stock image reflection map file from the project panel to the composition panel and resize it to the text layer. Search for motion tile from the effects and presets panel and apply into the reflection map layer and increase the output width and output height so that it fills the entire composition. Right click on the reflection map layer and click pre-compose. Name it as reflection map and click on the move all attributes and click OK. Change the track matte of the reflection map layer to alpha matte. Search for glass from the effects and presets panel and apply to the reflection map layer. Set the bump map to text stroke. Set the softness to 50, height to minus 50 and displacement to minus 500. Set the light type to point light. Search for CC Blobalize effect from the effects and presets panel and apply to the reflection map layer. Set the blob layer to text stroke layer. Set the property to alpha, softness to 5 and cutaway to 5. Set the light type to point light. Enter into the reflection map pre-composed layer and get into the reflection map PNG file and keyframe the tile center so that the file moves across the composition. go to the text composition and select the second text layer. Click on animate and choose tracking. In the tracking amount, set a value of 200, and at the beginning of the timeline, keyframe it to 200, and at around 2 seconds, set the value to 0. Let's ramp preview this. In the above text layer, to create the fade in effect, keyframe the opacity property. At around 2 seconds, keyframe the opacity property to 100. Go back for a few seconds and set it to 0. Now let's ramp preview this. Go to the metal text layer and ramp preview this. I feel the letters are more congested. Go back to the text layer and in the tracking amount, at around 2 seconds, set the value to somewhat like 15 or 20. And I'm choosing 15. Go back to that metal text layer. Now it's better. Bring in the smoke stock file to the composition. I would like the smoke to be coming out from the side of the text, so I am rotating the smoke file. And bring the smoke file to the top of the composition and change the blending mode to screen. Ramp preview this. Scale up the smoke stock file and reposition it. Scaling up furthermore. And repositioning it. Now that's looking better. Also, I am reducing its opacity to 35%. Ramp preview this. Now that's much better. Bring in the lens flare and drop down it below the smoke layer. Change the blending mode to add. Search for tint from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the lens flare file. Change the color to something that of the smoke layer. Let's ramp preview this. Go to the project panel and drag down the floor map to the composition panel. Change all the layers to 3D. Select the floor map and change the X rotation to something around minus 75 degree. Select the text layer, reflection map layer and the text stroke layer and right click to pre-compose them. Rename it to complete text. Select move all attributes and click OK. Select the floor map layer and reposition the floor map layer to something below the text layer. To fill up the width of the entire composition, scale the floor map layer and reposition it. Yeah, that would do. Duplicate the complete text layer. Search for compound blur from the effects and presets panel and apply it to the second complete text layer. Change the blur layer to flow and turn off the visibility of the floor layer. Flip this complete text layer vertically. Right click, transform, flip vertical. And reposition it make layers as 3D. Set the maximum blur value to 25. Let's RAM preview this. Bring down the opacity of the reflection layer to 50%. Also, I am creating a mask so that the first text layer alone gets reflected. I don't want the above laying text layer to get reflected. I am increasing the mask feather to get the natural look. Now let's RAM preview this. Create a new solid and name it as light. Search for gradient map effect from the effects and presets panel and apply into the light solid layer. The ramp shape, select radial ramp and click on swap colors. Change the white color to something that of the smoke color. Change the blending mode to add. Change the color center to wherever you like. I am trying out many things for better quality. Yeah, now it's looking better. Create a new solid layer and name it as particles. Search for CC particle systems 2 effect from the effects and preset panel and apply it to the particle solid layer and increase the radius X and Y values to something around 400. In the particle tab, choose particle type as shaded and faded sphere. Reduce the birth and death sizes of the particles. Change the color to whatever you want. I am choosing the same teal color from the background. Set the animation to direction. Set the direction value to 180 degree and the gravity to 0. Reduce the velocity to 0.5. RAM preview this. Increase the resistance value. Set the birth rate to 1 and longevity to 2. Let's RAM preview this. It's looking better. Right click and create a new solid layer and name it as film bar. Double click on the shape layer so that we get the mask for the entire composition size. In the mask one, select shape from the mask path. In the unit, select percentage of source. Set 12% for top and 88% for bottom. Select the inverted checkbox. and ramp review this. Create a new camera. Create a new null layer. Drag up the film bar layer above all the layers and parent the camera to the null layer. Make all the layers 3D. Create a keyframe for the position of the null object at the beginning of the timeline and increase the Z value to very high at around 6 seconds. Set the Z value back to 0. Create another null object. Parent the null 1 to null 2. Keyframe the position of the null object 2 at the end of the timeline. Set the Z value to 0. Keyframe the position of the null object 2 at around 20 seconds and set the Z value to 300. Now ramp review this. That's it. Let's see the output. The music used in this video is from No Copyright Sounds. I will leave a link in the description. If you want the track, you can check that out. That's it. I hope you liked this video. If you have enjoyed this video, consider subscribing. I will leave a link in the description. Also hit that like button and share it with your friends. Also, if you have anything to say, please feel free to comment down below. Once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching. Stay safe. This is Raudran signing off.